हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल डूइंग? एंड टुडे आई एम रियली हैप्पी बिकॉज इट्स द 20th एंड टुमारो वी हैव द ग्रेट कंजंक्शन, द ग्रेट कंजंक्शन ऑफ सैटर्न एंड जुपिटर. ओके, सो व्हाट इज ऑल दिस एक्साइटमेंट अबाउट इन द कम्युनिटी? ओके, व्हाट इज ऑल दिस अबाउट? सो बेसिकली व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इज इफ यू लुक एट सैटर्न एंड इफ यू लुक एट जुपिटर, ओके, दे आर पोलर ऑपोजिट्स. ओके, इट्स द पोलैरिटी. So Saturn represents the lower chakras, the 3D matrix, and Jupiter represents the higher chakras, the higher dimensions. And both of them are merging at 0 degrees on 21st December 2020, which is tomorrow, which happens in around 800 or 400 years. Okay, some say it's 400, some say it's 800, but it's a huge monumental event, okay, and this event is especially very important for the star seeds because after this event, there will be a lot less polarity in the world. So, all this excitement, all this noise about this event is happening because of the ending of polarity. We are going from one age to the other age, so we are going into the Aquarian age. So the Aquarian age is basically about freedom, okay? And what type of freedom are we talking about? We're not talking about the freedom that's happening on the national level, nations becoming free or states becoming free. Yes, that is part of the process that will happen, but real freedom is on the energetic level, okay? So Aquarius is about freedom, it's about sovereignty, and it's about a sovereign energy field. And this is where the real freedom happens. Because after this conjunction, we are going to move into a collective timeline where people will not be able to operate off of psychic cords, okay? So what polarity does it makes a certain group of people, it creates a power differential, okay? So there is a polarity between the masculine and the feminine, and the polarized masculine, whether it's a man or a woman, is basically siphoning off the energy of the polarized feminine, okay, because of the energetic imbalance. So these are all karmic professional relationship, karmic personal relationships, and a, you can say, karmic relationship with self. You know, it's not a unified state of consciousness. It is not a state where we are in self-love, but there are many aspects of us that are in a state of self-abandonment, okay. So the freedom is basically freedom from psychic cords, you know, because now, after the conjunction, what's really going to happen is the veil is thinning. Okay, the veil is thinning in the sense people will be more aware. There will be a heightened awareness because the upper chakras and the lower chakras are balancing. Okay, the 3D material reality and the spiritual reality is integrating. Okay, because Saturn represents Satan and Jupiter represents Guru or the Christ consciousness. So this is the integration of polarities. This is a union of the shadow self and the light self. So a lot of people will be pushed, forced, and thrown into shadow integration, into doing their own shadow integration process. So that is why, you know, this is going to be a great awakening in the sense it's going to be a mass awakening. Okay, because Jupiter does not denote a small event. Wherever Jupiter is involved, it denotes a mass awakening. So it's not going to be like a small group of people awakening or waves of people awakening like it used to happen before. Right now, what is happening is a mass awakening, which is on the global scale. Okay, because of the involvement of Jupiter and Jupiter conjuncting with Saturn. Okay. And another thing, if I come back to my main point, like why I'm really excited, and my guides were telling me, you know, like it's a time to be excited, it's a time to be happy, because now we are more aware regarding how we are controlling our energy, you know, how much power are we giving away, how are we controlling and directing our energy, how are we managing our energy. So the masses will be more aware of this, as in they will come out of the unconscious habitual patterns of giving their power away or taking power from somebody else. Okay, so they will be more aware of the energy exchanges that happen between relationships, and the people who had the power differential which was there, that is going to end. Okay, because they are no longer going to be siphoning off the energy off of the unconscious people, you know, off of the polarized feminine aspect. Because this is also relating to the balancing of the patriarchy, because the patriarchal structures, whether a man or a woman embodies them, are going to balance out, are going to be forced to be balanced out. Okay, because the new energies that are coming in are the energies of balance. They are the energies of integration, which are brought about by the Jupiter-Saturn conjunction. Okay, so then there are a lot of people who are talking about the solar flesh. Okay, now my guidance, I did not get anything about a solar flesh, but I know two things. Number one, there is going to be a solar flare. A lot of people are talking about it, which is a mass ejection from the sun. Okay, so the solar flare is happening, and I know there is going to be a huge release of energy from the galactic center. You know, the center of a galaxy, which is the great central sun known as Alcyone, if I'm not mistaken. The Mayans also used to call it Hunabku. Okay, Hunabku is the great central sun. It is the black hole, but actually there's a sun. In a higher dimension, it's a sun. So there's going to be a huge energetic release that is coming our way from the great central sun. And this is the energy of integration, of balance, of the higher mind. Okay, because the lower mind is the polarized mind, and the higher mind is the balanced mind. The higher mind is the third eye, which is the union of the feminine and the masculine, the Shiva and the Shakti. So those are the kinds of energies we are going to experience now. That too, it's special because it's happening on the mass scale. Okay, another thing is, I would like to go back to one event from the past. In the Indian mythology, it is said, it is narrated that when Kaliyug came, when that age of darkness came, all the gods and goddesses, like, they escaped from the earth. Okay, they knew that in the next 100 years the Kaliyuga is coming, so they all packed up their bags and they left the planet. Okay, but right now we are in such times where all the ETs are here, the star seeds are here, and they are among us. So why do you think they have come? You think they came without a plan? No. They came here because of the age of Aquarius. Because in the age of Aquarius, there were going to be mass awakenings, and people like us are needed here. The gods and goddesses have returned back. They have returned back because they are needed here, and this is their time. This is the age of Aquarius. Age of Aquarius is when the gods awaken, it's when the gods are grounding. Okay? And yes, this is a process. Because the energy is supportive of the higher frequencies, okay? And it is very harmful, and it is very negative, and it puts a lot of pressure on the lower frequencies, which are the unconscious constructs, okay? Whether it is in relationships, whether it is in the professional setting, wherever there is corruption, wherever there are unconscious constructs, they're not going to be standing for a long while in this energy of the Great Conjunction and of the age of Aquarius. Okay, so now I want to talk about the solar flare. As I was speaking, the solar flare, I haven't got much information about the solar flare, but I know that a huge huge energy is coming in, and a lot of people who are doing their work, whoever has been doing their work, they will absorb the energy. So you will absorb this energy based on your level, your capacity of absorbing, and where you are on the ascension process, right? So, what happens is, when people absorb this energy, it changes their system, it changes their chakra system, it helps them to evolve, it helps them to re release the blockages and balance the polarities, neutralize their system, and holographically, fractally, you begin to project a higher timeline, and you shift to a higher collective reality. So, basically, there are infinite timelines and there are infinite collective realities. Depending on your karma, you're projecting a certain timeline, and you're part of a certain collective reality. And the karma lies within your chakras, it lies within your light body system, your energetic system. Okay, so this is basically the next level of the light body activation. It depends on where you are on the light body activation scale. Okay, so this is going to be the next huge leap. Okay, so if somebody is at LBA, light body activation level 5, they will probably going to level 6 or level 7. If somebody is on the level 7, then they are probably going to go to level 8 or level 9, depending on their body and how much work they have done within themselves. So this is what basically people say when the timeline split is happening. Okay, it is happening on the individual level. What I have spoken of right now, it's the individual level. However, on the collective level, this timeline split is happening. Okay, Because whenever there is an ascension cycle, there is also a descension cycle. And a certain amount of time is given for people to make their choice. So some people, a lot of people have made their choice, or most of the people have made their choice. And there's going to be a timeline split at the collective level, because those who have chosen 3D and the descension cycle will be experiencing that collective in their personal reality, and those who have experienced those who have chosen 5D and awakening will be experiencing the different collective. Okay, so how is it going to be playing out on a practical scale in your life? So how it's going to be playing out is, you're not going to be interacting with those people who have chosen 3D as much. So you and your timeline will be separating. You'll be in your personal reality. A lot of change will occur. Relationships will drop, or you will see better versions of the people that you've seen. So this is basically working on the holographic timeline level. Either a person will leave your reality, or you will experience a better version of this person. In either case, it's a higher timeline. Okay, and if you are surrounded by negative people, and if you are experiencing negative versions of people, then you are on the lower timeline. You're shifting into the lower collective, and this is really dangerous. Okay, because there are two cycles, there are two paths. Okay, one is the descension cycle, one is the ascension cycle. Okay, so you better be on the ascension cycle. Okay, at least those people who are on my channel, I think most of them have chosen to awaken, chosen the ascension cycle, and I'm really happy about that. Otherwise, in most cases, you wouldn't be watching something like this. Okay, because what actually occurs on the personal practical level is your whole circle changes. Your circle changes, and you're no longer interacting with those people as much. And if they had any influence over your life, that influence kind of starts fading off, because the karma is not there. The karma in your system has been cleared. Okay, so that is what this incoming energy does, and this is why we have to meditate on these 2 days, today and tomorrow. You have to spend at least 3 hours on meditation. Okay, because of the energetic, huge energetic portal that is happening. It would be good if you just eat organic food or juices and things like that, because I personally don't feel like eating any solid food today. I just feel like having a juice or liquid diet. Okay, because I can feel my body preparing to receive the energies, and it has been receiving the energies since the 18th of December. Okay, so let me check if there's something else which I missed. Yeah, so there is one beautiful synchronicity that I would like to share with my tribe right now. See, this family where I'm born in, or where I'm posted in, I like to use the word posted because star seeds are always posted in certain areas where they have to do the energetic clearing. So in my house, on my roof, there was a lot of old unused iron. Okay, and that old unused iron basically stands for a lot of polarity karma. When you have a weak Saturn in your chart, or when you have a lot of Saturn karma, then you're usually, which is polarity, and I'm talking about it because the Jupiter Saturn conjunction. So that old waste iron which was lying on the roof of my house, that has been removed after like 12 or 13 years. So imagine, for 13 years, even though I tried to tell my parents to remove it, they had not removed it. It was like a store, it was just kept there. Somebody will come and take it or use it or whatever. It was basically waste iron, all the waste iron just lying on the roof. And it is very bad according to Vastu. According to Vastu, it's really bad. But for 12 years, it was lying there. And today, it has been removed. Okay, so this is one positive sign because of the Jupiter-Saturn conjunction. Okay, and there have been other positive signs also in my life regarding the relationship between the Saturn polarity aspect and the Jupiter higher self aspect. Okay, and since Saturn represents the masses, okay, and it represents the matrix. So when we have this Saturn Jupiter conjunction, what is happening is your lower three chakras are balancing out. They are not operating via polarity. Okay, your root chakra, sacral, and your सोलर प्लेक्सस विच आर द थ्री डी चक्रास, द थ्री डी रियलिटी चक्रास, द फिजिकल रियलिटी चक्रास, दे आर नॉट ऑपरेटिंग ऑफ ऑफ पोलैरिटी, यू नो दे आर बैलेंसिंग आउट. ओके, सो दैट इज सैटर्न एंड जुपिटर्स एनर्जीज कमिंग टुगेदर, विच इज इंटीग्रेशन. ओके, दैट इज द मैस्कुलाइन फेमिनाइन हायर सेल्फ लोअर ईगो सेल्फ इंटीग्रेटिंग. Okay, so yeah, I spoke about the timeline split. I spoke about the veil shifting, polarity integration, Satan and Christ, healing of our shadow self. Yeah, and the conjunction is happening at 0 degrees of Capricorn, and from 0 to 1 degrees, Jupiter and Saturn are going to be together. Okay, it's going to be a beautiful sight, you know, kind of like the star that showed up when Christ was born, and the three wise men, they followed the star. So Jupiter and Saturn are going to combine together, and it's going to look like one star, you know, because they are conjuncting at 0 degrees. So there aren't, you're not going to see it as two planets, you're going to see it as one star. Okay, another thing is I've been seeing 222 a lot these days. For the last 1 week, I could say, because 222 is duality integration. Two basically represents duality. Okay, two represents duality, and when you see triple two, it means a balancing of the material and the spiritual. Okay, so that's duality integration. And yeah, one thing I would like to say is, I was asking my higher self, when will my twin awaken? And yesterday I got the message that this is the year my twin will awaken, because in my astrology chart, my twin shows up as Saturn, okay? And I show up as Jupiter in his chart, because I'm the spiritual twin and he's the matrix twin. So when the matrix is awakening on the mass scale, that is when my twin will be awakening. So this is the year when my twin flame is finally awakening. Okay, and I'm really, really happy about that. I was crying about that because I was so emotional, but now I've, you know, released all those emotions. And it was such, because when I got the download, I got the download in the morning that, yeah, this is the year my twin will be awakening, because our charts are kind of synchronized with the collective reality, you know. So where the collective is going, we are flowing with the collective, because we have incarnated here at that particular time. And so our charts and our life cycles, me and my twin, are synchronized with the collective reality and their progress also. So a lot of collective energy like that in my chart and my twin's chart as well. Okay, so one last thing I would like to say about this conjunction is that there are a lot of people who are spreading misconceptions about this conjunction, you know. And but it's a good thing that they're talking about it, because now you can clearly identify who is who, you know, who is happy about the conjunction and who is really frustrated about the conjunction. Because if you just close your eyes and tune into their voice, you can see the hate, you can see the frustration in their voice, because this conjunction is happening. And why are they angry, hateful, and frustrated about this conjunction? And they're trying to downplay this conjunction. Okay, first of all, they are really mad at the star seeds. Okay, they are saying, like, you know, we think of ourselves as a hierarchy. No, we are a hierarchy. Okay, I will clearly say it. You like me or you hate me, we are a hierarchy, because the main difference between star seeds and humans is that I've noticed that star seeds have this natural inborn tendency where they own their issues. Okay, whereas humans, they will always project their issues. That is like their default. Okay, so there is a huge difference between star seeds and humans, basically because star seeds came here to take on the karma which they never had. You know, they are volunteers. Okay, they have done a great service to humanity by coming here, and on top of that, faced a lot of rejection, because, you know, obviously humans project, right? They don't own their issues. So I see a lot of people downplaying this whole Jupiter-Saturn conjunction, because they are really mad that they're not going to be operating through psychic cords anymore. They're not going to be operating through power differential anymore. Since the veil is thinning, a lot of people who were unconscious will be able to see their manipulative strategies, right? So they're going to lose their followers. Okay, they are going to be able to clearly see all the manipulative, the solar plexus cords through which they are controlling them, through which they are attached to them. They are going to be seeing it. Okay, so no longer they are going to have this power differential and feeding off of the masses through their manipulative strategies. Okay, so this whole pattern of operating off of psychic cords is going to be cut. It's going to be stopped because we are entering into the Aquarian is where we are functioning through sovereign energy field. And if everybody comes into a state of sovereignty and balance, how can they operate via psychic cord? So they will be forced to do their shadow work. Okay. And of course, the ego reacts to that. The ego is frustrated about that. Okay. So then they will try to. I've watched other videos and I have seen how people are trying to downplay this whole event that is happening. Okay, and actually, this event is the event that was predicted in 2012. Okay, but they made a mistake. It was not 2012, it was actually 2021. And how do I know it? Because it shows up in my chart. You know, 2021 shows up in my chart as the year of the fifth dimension, as the year of ascension. And not only does it show up in my chart through my own chart readings, I had before my activation, I had also taken a psychic reading from a really good psychic, and she had also mentioned that this will be the year of 5D for me. Okay, and if this is the year of 5D for me, it is the year of 5D for the entire collective, because as I said, our charts are synchronized with the collective. Okay, we have a lot of collective energy in the chart, me and my twin. Okay, so yeah, Jupiter Saturn conjunction is a really great time to celebrate. It's a time where through divine grace the blockages in your chakras are going to be cleared and you're going to be projecting a higher timeline where you're not going to let people manipulate you mentally, you're not going to let people manipulate you emotionally, you're not going to operate off of psychic cords in relationship. You're going to speak up, you're going to ask people to own their shit, own their issues, and clear it and then come and relate with you. Okay. So a lot of upheaval is coming. You know, these are happy times, but these are definitely not stable times. Okay. Lot of instability I sense in the collective because the sleeping masses are going to awaken right now, right? Aquarius. What is Aquarius? Aquarius is the natural 11th house. Okay. It is the house of the common masses, the collective masses. Okay. So if there is instability and awakening always brings instability on such a huge level. So imagine the upheaval on the collective level, which is huge. Okay. And Jupiter is going to make sure that the systems are all fixed, the corrupt systems come into a level of balance and alignment. And this is happening on the personal level as well as on the government structure level. You know, it's happening on the professional level, the personal level, energetic level, every level. Okay, so this is basically what I have to share about the Great Conjunction. It's a wonderful time. This shift occurs once in 800 years or once in 400 years. And a lot of people are saying that this is the time where, you know, even the negative people, you know, if they have chosen to awaken, they will be awakening. So you're going to see a lot of hardcore negative people, you know, who were very attached to their negative identity and their comfort zone in terms of power imbalances, they are going to awaken because they are going to experience a sort of a soul shock. Okay. And those that are not going to awaken, those who have chosen not to awaken, you know, will not be interacting with them so much. So realities are going to split. Okay. The 5D collective is going to be splitting from the 3D collective. Okay, so this is what I have to share with you today, and as usual, I would like to sign off and say, wish you all a great week, wish you all a great Christmas season, and love you all.